What is up there, everyone? It's the guy from the Gamertag here, and I wanted to talk about what has happened to Team Deathmatch in COD over the years, because in my personal opinion, it's got quite a lot worse in the most recent games. Because back in the day, and actually when I go back and play the older games, I actually used to play TDM a lot. It was pretty much my main mode, and that's just because for me, Call of Duty is just a point and shoot kind of game. I don't want to take it particularly seriously anymore, just because it doesn't kind of fit that for me. I'm looking for more casual gaming now, because just generally, I am enjoying gaming more, playing it a bit more casually. However, at times, of course, you always do want to be a little bit competitive. But the way Team Deathmatch used to work was you'd almost have like base spawns, almost like in Battlefield in a way. One team would spawn at one end of the map, the other would spawn at the other end of the map. And the initial conflict between the two teams was what would cause, which basically would almost set out for the game which team is going to win. Because the team that pushed up and was the most effective team or had the best players on it would kill off the enemy team, and they would then be pushed back to where they originally spawned, and they would have a small area where they would be spawning. It is then down to the team who lost that initial fight to get out of that area quickly, otherwise they're going to be spawn trapped. Because if you don't get out of that area quickly, what happens is the enemy team can then push up and basically surround you, and it's very difficult to get out of the spawn trap. The only way the spawns flip is if they just do it. Occasionally they might flip just slightly randomly, but often it was just because someone pushed too far into the spawn and then the spawns flipped around to the other side of the map. And I thought that was really good design, because it kind of rewarded the more coordinated or better team or just better players. And actually it did also reward better players, because if you were on the losing team but you were still a good player, you knew how to move around the map, you knew how to flank and attack the enemies from behind, you could get around and get a lot of kills and do damage to the enemy team that was trying to trap you because you were a better player. And that was something I really enjoyed, because it kind of made you think more about how you were going to approach it. Because you had to either sit back and just kill the enemies as they came towards you, or you flank around them and then you try and get them from behind, which is always really rewarding when you can do it. I've had one game, it was on Pipeline, I think it was called, on COD 4, where I was just flanking underneath the ground. It may be the gameplay in the background, it really depends on how long this commentary goes for. But I was just flanking in the tunnels underneath the map, and I got quite a lot of kills. Yeah, I could have done better in the game had I played a bit smarter when I was in the enemy's bases. But at the same time, I had a lot of fun just being rewarded for having my knowledge of the map and the way to go around it in the safest way for me. And it was just a lot of fun. Now, COD 4 and Modern Warfare 2 did this a lot, and I really enjoyed it. In fact, TDM is actually the modes I play more on those games, just because I find it fun to play. And also, there's generally more players in TDM, so I can get better connections in it. Now, Modern Warfare 3 had sort of a similar system, but then they also had the revenge spawns, which is where when you get killed by someone, you'll spawn near them so you can get a revenge kill on them, which really kind of made it slightly more random, which really didn't make the game mode as fun, and that's where I started to play other modes. In fact, Modern Warfare 3, I played Demolition, because that way the actual spawns were more like TDM, where you had two different bases, one team on one side, one team on the other. However, the spawns would flip very chaotically at times, but it just made it fun. For me, Demolition was extended TDM with bombs. It was really, that was just it. It was just kill, kill, kill. Oh, one sec, the timer's going to run out. Let's blow up one of the bomb sites so we can have another 10 minutes or so just killing and killing. It was quite a lot of fun. And then in Black Ops 2, they have a very similar spawn system to the way it worked in COD 4 and Modern Warfare 2, where you've got one team spawning in one area, one team spawning in the other. The only problem, and the reason why I like it a lot less than in COD 4 and Modern Warfare 2, was that in the Infinity Ward games, where it would spawn you, there was some essence of cover. The enemies could get fairly close to you and flush you out of your little hiding spots if you had teammates that were just sitting there and taking it, taking all the deaths, which is really quite annoying when people don't push out, because you get trapped and it does get annoying. But the enemies could get fairly close to you, but there was enough cover so that if you were a smart player, you could actually work your way out of it. You could move your way out of the spawn trap. But in Black Ops 2, the way the spawns seemed to work and how you could push into them, you seemed to have quite a fair amount of distance between where the enemy team could trap you and where you were spawning, and that was the problem. It made it very difficult to get out of the spawn traps. The one that sticks into my head the most is Hijacked, where you would, because you've got two buildings as such, you've got the two little buildings at both sides of the map, and then you've got the two spawn areas at either end of the boat. And you could trap them from the buildings, and they would spawn at the end of the boat, and it was really irritating because you had lots of open ground. Well, it wasn't too far, but it was a fair amount of open ground to cover with very limited cover for you. You had to get across all this open ground before you could get to some sort of safety, and that was why the spawn trapping for me was absolutely horrendous. Admittedly, it's partly your own fault for having not played well enough in that opening conflict, but it was just annoying that you couldn't actually work your way out of it because it was so sort of laned. There's like, I get why laned maps are very good and they help the flow of the game, but the laning was very restricted. You couldn't really get out of the trap unless someone pushed in and flipped the spawns, which is something quite annoying. Then on to Ghosts and Advanced Warfare, the spawning in Ghosts seemed almost random, and TDM was mostly killed by the fact that this was the game where it almost certainly turned into camper deathmatch. It really was awful, the amount of campers in the game. People would just sit anywhere there was a corner or a dark area, there was going to be someone sitting there, and it was just horrendous to play. That was mostly down to game design, that was a flaw, and why TDM really just didn't work in Ghosts. And in Advanced Warfare, I think it's just the EXO is why TDM doesn't work. I can't really judge the spawns in Advanced Warfare, firstly because I haven't really played it in ages. I just haven't had really an interest to go back and play it. And I never played TDM because it was so random. There were people everywhere, you're getting shot from the side, and I preferred playing the objective modes like Uplink, and sometimes Momentum, but mostly Uplink I enjoyed because I kind of like those sort of capturing game modes in more recent games. And what it does is the objective kind of focuses where people are usually going to be. There of course are some kill whores, which gets a bit annoying because that's something that always has bugged me, is people who go around killing in objective modes, and because they got a fair amount of kills, they can be the most valued player, yet if you've captured all the objectives, you come below them, and that's something that really does irritate me a little bit. But I found that it was just more fun for me to play in objective mode because it focused where people were going to be. But I really think TDM needs to go back to the way it was, where you have base spawns, where the initial conflict between the two teams was what set up the game. If you did well in that initial conflict, you could then pin the enemy team back and just kind of hold them there for most of the game. Or you could always push in and you could make it random and just have it like that. If your team had the advantage, you could do whatever you wanted with the game. You could pin them back, or you could go in and make them flip across, and you could have a lot of running and gunning battles. But also, if you're on the losing end, you can still flank around and still make a comeback and actually do some damage to the enemy team. And that was why I love TDM in the older games. But I want to hear what you guys think, because this is something that I've thought about a lot, because I do enjoy TDM, and the reason why I still go back to some of the older CODs every now and then is because I like how point and shoot they are. They're very simple, and I don't have to do much to get into the game. And TDM is just a really easy way to do that. It's just kill all the things. But anyway, guys, this has been the guy with no gamertag, and I'll see you on another video.